Hello, so this video will have two parts and of course timestamps. We'll speak about farming, about taming the boars, raising the boars, boar farm. And in the second part of the video, we'll speak about carts, how to build bridges, because you can actually build bridges, not on a large scale, not across the ocean, but if you have an archipelago or just, a collection of islands like this, you can probably build it around places like this. Places like this, I mean, especially for places like this with the Black Forest where you have a lot of natural resources like copper, tin, and of course a lot of wood, a lot of berries, a lot of skeletons to kill. It's all about putting a good place for your main base, and that's how your supply chains will start. Now, let's speak about the boars. First of all, nobody really knows how they work because it seems to be a little randomized. I have caught them for about 2 days, and each time I go close to them, they actually freak out like that and will start attacking the fence. So I tried watching them during the night, I tried watching them from a very, very far distance, and they're not actually calming down. So I guess they just need more time, and you need more time to spend away from your base. It's pretty easy to build the fences, and then you just build a normal wooden door, and then they just follow you, open the door, go inside, jump the fence, and kill them. I mean, not kill them, sorry, that's a bad way of saying it, and trap them. Now, as you can see, I've thrown a lot of food on the ground, and as long as the food is in your workshop or your workstation or whatever you want to call it area, it will not be destroyed, it will not degrade. The workbench will actually protect your food from disappearing. Now, I've thrown the yellow mushrooms, but to be honest, the ones that really work are, of course, the carrots and the regular mushrooms. So, mushroom, carrots, best food to feed them. I think they ate a carrot or two from this place, but they're not really tame yet, so we'll just leave them alone. By the way, you also have to check the fence. You have to go over here and repair it because they'll attack it sometimes. And sometimes they'll attack the gate a lot of times, so be careful. Don't let your guard down because they can destroy the fence or, it can be destroyed and then they can escape. And when they actually have a few purple hearts above, then that means they're tamed. And then when you actually leave them alone for longer, they'll actually be, together and make a little baby piglet, a baby pig, and then you can wait until that's big and you can eat it then. Now, if you get 1-star boars, you can actually make them, tame them and breed them, but I heard it's randomized. Sometimes you'll get 1-star boars from the normal boars as well, so yeah. There is a lot of information, so let me show you how it's done. Of course, this is on the meadows because your main base should always be on the meadows. And the boar has to be frightened then, and he will actually follow you and try to kill you. Good luck, little boar. The pen doesn't have to be too big, but to be honest, I think it should be much bigger than this because it should almost be double the size of this because you need a lot of space for the boars to run and, of course, a lot of space for the new piggies. Hey, where did that boar go? Hey, I invite him to my house and this is how he repays me. He just vanishes into thin air. Come on, little piggy. Sometimes it takes a while, so make sure you are watching them very, very closely. Hey, there you go. I believe they'll starve to death if they don't eat anyway. Like I said, this is just for fun. They're not actually the glowing mushrooms, but I want to watch them at night. Okay, now let's go to the farming portion. Let's leave them alone because we need to feed them with carrots. The main reason for this, even if you are playing alone, you will not have enough resources to feed yourself. So I actually tried to feed myself with only the berries that spawn on this huge map, and the berries, I mean the berries from this map and the berries from the Black Forest in general, but they don't spawn fast enough for you to get good quality food. So it's going to be a while until you get it. Now, you need to access the bronze bars and you need to build a cultivator, which is done from the forge. As you can see, 5 bronze bars and corwood. Corwood is found from the pine wood, the Black Forest. Man, they are sure loud. Also, I have a few cloudberries from the plains. Yeah, if you don't know where the plains are, don't ask. You will not go there and you will not like it. So let's actually try it with cloud berries, even though they're from the plains, but technically still a berry. Now, how do I know this? Well, the facts are very simple. If you go over here and you search the runes, eventually you'll find a lore for the boars. And let them eat off your stock, roots of the ground are their pleasure. So let's throw a few cloud berries in here. And also 3 carrots. Eventually they should calm down and eat it. But again, you have to have mushrooms and carrots. At least, in principle. Otherwise, you can try with the berries, they'll eat them, but it'll be slower, maybe. Now, how do you farm? Well, I suggest, first of all, you need some defenses, because even on the most basic map with, like this one, the meadows, your crops will actually get attacked. So I recommend you build it near your house, raise the ground like this, so it's impossible for you to run up with it. So enemies can jump, use that to your advantage. Because what I found out is that the boars and even the little grey dwarfs will actually attract your crops. And they'll attack them and destroy them, and that's not good for you. And to be honest, they will attack them no matter what you're doing. So even if you're not in the base, they'll attack them and destroy them. So, okay, we also have some other stuff over here. You can plant the trees over here, but that's not important. In order to cultivate, you'll actually destroy the grass area. And if you want to restore the grass area, you can just make it like this. Yeah, let's make everything soft and fluffy for the enemy. Let's hide the dangers. Okay, you can also, if you are really mad about them destroying your crops, you can also put the sharp stakes over here. This works extremely, extremely well. Now, as for the farming, it uses three simple principles. One is you find the seed and you plant it, for example, turnip or carrot. As you can see, the carrot will use a carrot seed. That's the basic principle. The second principle is that they need a lot of ground and possibly sun. So, from what I can see, they need about one tile away. So, something like this. You can actually put them something like this a little closer, but sometimes they'll just not grow because they'll say they are too close to each other. Elfie? Healthy. So if it says it's healthy, that means it will grow. So if it's not healthy, it will not grow, and you can't do anything about it, sadly. Now, how do you get back the seeds? Because that's the main problem some people have. We still have 9 carrots, so you get a carrot, and then you are supposed to plant the seeds again with a carrot. So 1 carrot, for example, will give you 3 seeds, but remember, you have to plant it with this interface. So this is how you get carrots from the seeds. This is how you get seeds from the carrots. It seems a little more complicated, right? But that's the way it's been done. And again, I recommend you check if they're healthy or not, because that will depend on your crop placement. Sadly, there is not much you can do about it. You can drop a few stones so you know how much to limit yourself, because I planted 100 carrots near each other, and guess what? They all disappeared. I wasted about 200 seeds just by doing silly stuff like this. So, as you can see, I have a few turnip seeds, and also a few turnips. So let's actually harvest them, because I need to plant them again. I'm not sure about the sun requirement, but again, it's better to be sure than sorry. So we have the turnips and the turnip seeds. Now, your ratio should be about 1 to 3, you plant again. So if you have 100 seeds, 100 turnips, 30 of them you should replant. Otherwise, you'll just keep losing and losing. So that's why farming is so complicated. You need a lot of time, you need a lot of space, you need a lot of patience, you need a lot of planning, and you also need a bit of luck, to be honest, because if you don't find a good base location, you'll be basically wasting your time. So that was the turnips to eat, to make the turnips stew. Now, again, I just like to put them wherever they are, doesn't really matter. Healthy. You can probably put them closer, but again, I don't really want to risk it. healthy. And that's about everything you need to know. And this was 10 minutes, so this is literally you farming for 10 minutes and then you have to wait longer to actually reap the rewards from that. These guys are still very angry at me, sorry about this. Now, about the bridges and the carts, well, let's go and get the nails before I forget. Because you'll need the bronze nails to actually build a cart. I guess the cart is a little underwhelming because you can just build a boat or a car, which will do basically the same thing except it will go over the ocean. So let's actually test it a little bit, how efficient it is. Yeah, having so many drawers is not always the best idea. Okay, let's arrange that a little bit, and we only need 10 nails. Now, if you're wondering why am I doing with the hoe, well, the hoe is actually one of your most useful tools. Because you can use it to lower the ground or raise it. Now, you can also level it, which will remove all the grass in one hit, which is super useful. You can also raise the ground, and you can also pathen. Which is not really something that you'll use a lot, but again, it's there, and you might as well use it. So this is how you actually make it. If the ground is too low, you actually can raise it a little bit to make a little platform over here. Again, this base is near the mountain for a reason. I had access to a lot of stone, and I still have a lot of stone. Now let's go and build that cart over there, because we need to speak about bridge building. As you can see, they are still very angry. We'll leave them alone. They'll take their anger on the fence. Now, like I said, if you have something like this, which is very easy to cross, you might as well try to build a bridge, and if it doesn't work, well, you'll at least have an easier time jumping on the water. I mean, jumping on the bridge itself, so you don't have to swim all of that way. Now, from what I know, the buildings degrade over time, or especially when it's raining. But it's pretty hard for them to be destroyed in the Black Forest. And I think when they reach about 50% or 40% of their HP, they just stay like that forever. I'm not sure if they're actually going to get destroyed, but the enemies will attack them sooner or later. But again, on this map, this has been alive for about 5 days now. Now, how do you build a bridge? Well, it's simple. You need to start somewhere like this, on the shore. And when you get to the deeper water, you just use the poles, because the poles are actually supporting poles. So this is the longest one. I have one over here just for show and tell. But these are not actually the ones that are supporting the structures. The ones that are supporting the structures are actually hidden under the water. So let me show you. That's why you have different sizes to them. See? That actually snaps on. So that was a snapped on. And then you can actually build it, the bridge normally. So you need to support it underwater. As you can see, that's a supporting pillar. That's, I think, a supporting pillar. And I have a few of them over there as well. Now it's a lot better to build this in the forest because you have enough wood over here. Otherwise, you just have to carry a lot of wood with you. And again, they will have problems maintaining this, so I have one over there to start off the bridge. And I also have one over here, which is actually the main bone of the bridge. And to be honest, I only needed this one, because this one was far enough to build everything, see? Let me actually show you what happens when a troll tries to kill you. See, you can just hide and he'll go away. He'll not actually attack your buildings, and they're quite docile, to be honest, for what they're supposed to be. He's a troll bridge right now. Or a bridge troll. Hey! That was not fair. But hey, I don't know why. But it seems it does a lot more damage if you hit them in the grass area. Again, don't ask me, ask the developers. so angry. And that's how you handle the trolls. Ultimate disrespect. And the game will actually spawn a few trolls, but as you can see, they're not really attacking you, so that's the good side of the thing. Now, let's go over to the resources area of the map, because that's what we're here for. And sadly, you also have to clear along the path sometimes. Yeah, I don't think the cart is currently implemented the right way, but we'll just have to see how it works out. Again, your main supply route should always be kind of unhidden, so you should destroy the trees and all of the stuff near the berry bushes so you can better see them, and you can also build a little bit of a breadcrumb trail so you know what route to do for the best loot. Sorry about the longer explanations, but most of the stuff will not work if you are not prepared. And hey, that's the name of the game, being prepared. Now usually I found a lot of tin and copper near the shore, so yeah. We should find some over here as well. Again, this works amazingly well the first time you are playing the game and you make your main base near the Black Forest. That's a tin deposit. Let's actually go over to the copper deposit. There is another troll around here, I can smell him. It's empty. Okay, of course you come along now, because I said there is a troll nearby and I can hear him. Again, more damage to the grass area, I don't know why. 88. Actually hit me with your club. 105. Hey, it's an easy way to kill a troll, so why not? Now, let's mine a little bit. As you can see, we had some tin over there. We had some copper over here, tin over there, and a lot more tin over the shore. Yes, the glorious joy of mining. Hip hip hooray. I'm not sure what's the weight limit on this thing, but as you can see, it says only the weight it currently has. So, sorry I couldn't, you know, tell you more information, but I can tell you it's going to be a lot of room. Of course, you don't want to spend the night over here, because the night is the most dangerous time when a lot of dwarves will come. Okay, now let's actually take this back to our base so we can see how much time we need to do it. They actually attack the cook. Okay, you little monsters, I'm so tired of you. Also, when it's getting dark like this, I really recommend you put up a standing torch, but I don't have enough resin, come on. It's super useful, I mean, you basically can see 50% more. Okay, that's all the mining I wanted to do. Where is my copper ore? Come on, give me a copper ore so I can live in peace. Now, the bosses, or not actually the bosses, but the enemies seem to spawn whenever you spend too much time in a certain area. So if you spend a lot of area in the Black Forest, sometimes the enemy will just come for you like that. Finally, we have a copper piece. Out of my way, I'm busy. I said, oh come on, this is so silly. Yeah, this is not really worth it doing at night. And like I said, you need to clear a lot of the pathways, but once you get the hang of things, you'll be able to do this a lot more a lot more reliable. Remember, you can also run with the cart if you are feeling like you don't have enough time to spend. The cart actually does a good job of at climbing stuff, but again, you might want to be more careful. Since it can break like that. And this is why I think the cart is not really exploited the way it should be. It's way too easy to lose it, it's way too easy to get attacked. So you need to create a clear pathway. This is not in the right position, you have to be kidding me. This is some kind of a... Okay, let's actually increase the gamma a little bit so you can see what I have to deal with. So I strongly think the cart was made for squads. Well, it's still hanging on there. Nope, I'll not play with any more of you guys. Well, the... Okay, this has turned out to be a true experience. Again, it's a lot easier if you just have the right pathways, otherwise you just have to clear so much road. Cart, are you feeling okay? If you need help, say. And I'll be right there with you. This is why I think you need a cart to mine the copper ore, but otherwise, you might just as well run around the map. And you also need some kind of a signal source over there, like a fire. This is also another reason why, if you're playing alone again, you just need to make a few workbenches around the map so you have enough time to repair your stuff. Or even sometimes cook. Okay. Without the bridge, carts I think would have been totally useless. Leave me alone, you little monster. Hey, drop it. I think they need a way to repair the cart or something like that, because otherwise you'll just have to spend too much time just repairing stuff. Okay, and I also have to clear this area, because if it's full of trees like that, you'll not be able to cross it. Okay. Okay, that also needs to come down. And like I said, you kind of need to build your own pathway, leave a breadcrumb trail or something, leave a lot of marks in the ground. I mean, even at this point, even if it gets destroyed by the little dwarves, it will still be a good investment because, hey, you made it closer to your base. So before you leave the forest, just repair it and also make a few more repair points along the way. Yeah, this is a little bit silly. And I think this is far up. Stop. Oh, now you don't want to fight anymore. Okay, the last one, and then we'll actually look at something else. That's a very hard experience make it resemble something else. So you can have about 300 kilograms or pounds on you. Then you can also fill a car like this, and you can also bring more material types. How badly was it damaged? Very badly. Oh, Okay, let's see if we can bring it a little closer to the base without actually smashing it so I can repair it. This is probably as good as it's going to get. Now, you have to always protect the cart, and even in here you have to protect it, so... Meh. The boars are still running around, meaning we have to let them cool down a lot longer than this. Also, remember to check the fence. As you can see, sometimes it will get more smashed. So in the beginning, I suggest you try it 3 or 4 boars only. that's kind of like the moral of the story. A lot of patience is needed for this game. Anyway, see you next time. Bye.